just now clearly demonstrates the conventional way of gate entrance system. Face recognition is an amazing technology and method that can identify the face of a person. My name is Yusra Mehreen, and I'll be introducing you to the main idea of our project, which is able to solve the problems of these poor students and any organization whatsoever. Face detection is a system which detects the human face. Face detection comes before face recognition, where human features are scanned to give recognition of that person, which is matched with the stored data. In today's world of technological advancement, this method can be very useful for surveillance systems, intelligent robots, digital monitoring, and any security-related issues. The system of our project is designed in such a way where there will be a live video recording on the surveillance system, and a real-time authentication information will be sent to the authorized person. If there is any unauthorized person entering the system or the organization, then a buzzer will be made.
Now I am going to explain the hardware part of this project.
We are using Raspberry Pi for signal processing. It is a RISC processor designed by Advanced RISC Machines. This board is intended to run Linux-based operating system. This is Raspberry Pi 3. It has 4 USB ports, 1 Ethernet port, and 1 HDMI port. We connect a monitor to Raspberry Pi using a HDMI cable. This main processing chip connects a camera and display. USB camera is imaging camera that use USB technology to transfer image data. USB camera using low power USB port. Additionally, we are using a buzzer. When our software detects an unknown face, buzzer will turn on.
Hello, I'm AK Mawanatullah. I will demonstrate how our project works and also explain the codes that we use. As you can see, we have turned on our Raspberry Pi and connected the Raspberry Pi to our monitor using an HDMI cable. We have also connected a mouse, a keyboard, and our Logitech webcam to the Raspberry Pi. So now let us open the terminal. And first we need to enter the OpenCV environment. Now we have to run the RecordFace Python file. So let us see the code. So first we have to capture a video, and from the video we will take about 20 screenshots, and those 20 screenshots will be saved to a particular name. And from those 20 pictures, we will use the Parcascade Formical Face classifier to create our dataset. So let's run the record face file. So after running, it tells us to enter a name. So my name is Awana. And see, it's now capturing 20 photos. After 20 photos, it turns off. Now we will train our dataset using the trainer.py file. In this code, we train our dataset with the LBPH face recognizer. So now let's train our dataset. Now we will run the detector.py file. In this code, we take a video from our webcam and we can recognize a face in real time. So now let's detect a face. So we go to the terminal. As you can see, it perfectly recognizes my face and is giving the corresponding value. Next, we'll see how our project works when it detects multiple faces. Now we're in Drake University Computer Lab. We have connected all the hardwares, and now let's start.
Project can be used in universities, schools, colleges, offices, and many other places to control access. This can be also used for giving attendance automatically. Besides, by keeping record of access, crime rates can be reduced and criminals can be captured too. This can be used in the virtual world too. Apple has already implemented this feature in their latest flagship device for unlocking. Other devices will be able to use face recognition. Besides logging in, any user ID such as Facebook, Twitter, or Amazon, etc. by putting face recognition as a password can be revolutionary. Face ID can be used for cash payments too. Swiping cards or writing out PIN numbers can be quite risky. So if you use our face password as an alternative access option, this will definitely become really, really safe.
To end this video, finally I'd like to say is that the aim of our project was to create a low-cost face recognition system to overcome everyday entry system hassle. Our project can easily be implemented with minimal cost into any facility because it requires less resources and very simple to use. Now, if we compare our project with a pre-existing system, then we can say that our project is a basic implementation for face recognition, but the result we generate is real-time. Furthermore, improvements can be done on the project using machine learning into algorithms. But the main goal of the project should be to create a secure system, eliminating the manual recognition system because it requires more hassle. Thank you everyone for staying with us.